Did you know skin tumors are the most common tumors in dogs and cats, and some breeds are at a higher risk than others? Richmond veterinarian Dr. Danielle Spencer joins us this morning with her dog, Farah, telling us more about what we need to know if we have four-legged friends. It's great to see you again.
You too.
And Farah, nice to meet you. Yes, you look very comfortable. Things are good.
How are you doing?
We can get you some water, maybe.
She's just chilling.
Yeah, she's chilling. It's Friday. That's a good thing to do.
Yeah.
We're having an important conversation today. Danielle, you and Farah have been friends for 12 plus years,
yes.
Right? They become members of our family.
Absolutely.
And health is very important to us. And nobody wants to think about this developing in their cat or dog, but it's something that we really need to be aware about.
Absolutely. And, you know, as much as we pet our dogs all the time and, you know, we take them to the groomers and we do vaccinations and do all of that, you also just want to, you know, always just kind of pet them and, you know, make sure that there are no lumps and bumps, because they can sometimes just kind of pop up out of nowhere. For instance, you know, my other dog, Mac Daddy, had a growth in his ear, just kind of popped up out of nowhere. And then just monitoring something like that to make sure that it doesn't become a problem.
How often should we be checking?
I would say every time you're petting them.
Yeah, just
because
kind of.
I mean, not to be neurotic about it, but anytime you're petting, you may pet a different area from time to time, and especially maybe looking on the belly, because that's not an area that we look at all the time, or even back by the rear end. But especially, I would say the face and the head tend to be common areas that we do see growths actually on pets.
What causes this skin cancer in dogs and cats?
Yeah, there are a couple of things. There actually are certain breeds actually that are more predisposed, for instance, like boxers, shih tzus, Labradors, for instance. But sometimes the sun can play a role, you know, certainly in terms of skin tumors. Unspayed females is very common, especially for like breast cancer. And also sometimes it could, you know, they have linked sometimes to food. Vaccinations definitely play a role in cats, especially. So there are a couple of different factors.
Once you've been doing the check and maybe you feel something, maybe you encounter something, what is the next step? You said kind of monitor it, be aware, but what's our next step?
So I would check it and first see if it even, you know, is bothering the pet, because, you know, certainly it can have like a little pimple that, you know, like us, and it may come to a head and burst. If it remains, if it's bothering the pet, especially if it's open and ulcerated and bleeding, you certainly would like to have your vet take a look at it. And what they'll do is they'll just take a little sample of it, maybe a cellular sample, send it out to the lab and see what type of a growth it is. Because many times they can have it removed and, you know, we're done with it. You don't want it to progress, and, you know, perhaps if it is a malignant growth, you don't want it to, you know, act aggressively and spread.
In doing these checks, we're petting our cat or dog, and you may not encounter something, but you may notice some other behavioral signs.
Right. Sometimes, because especially, you know, dogs do like to scratch at their ears a lot, and it could just be water in there. But sometimes you might find a little growth behind the ear that they're scratching at consistently. And that is definitely strange. Or if they're whining, if they're, you know, rubbing their butt sometimes, a lot of dogs do that. It's usually an indication of some type of an irritation.
You'll notice that. Your friends, I mean,
yeah,
you're around each other every day.
Yeah, because you know their behavior, right.
You'll encounter those unusual behaviors. And as this happens, treatment typically?
Treatment is definitely surgical removal. That would be ideal. Occasionally, they need to be followed up with, you know, chemotherapy, certainly in the event if it is malignant. And then also radiotherapy. You know, radiation is sometimes used as well.
Yeah, good to be aware. Thank you for giving us the 411 on that.
Sure thing.
Thanks, Farah. Happy Friday. Great job. Love it. You're welcome back anytime. She's like, give me one of those cookies. Thanks for coming in today, Dr. Danielle.